So the minute you don't put a, you know, a God on your mind, it means anything can come to you. Anything can come to you. Anything can come to your mind. You know, you are free. You can mingle anywhere. You can browse any website. You are the most dangerous man on earth. Because it means anything goes. It means you are just a bunch of disaster going somewhere to happen. You browse anywhere, you watch anything, you listen to any and everything. You are just available for every kind of junk. You have no guard, you have no, you have no borderlines, you have no protective device, nothing. You are just exposed. Anybody can talk to you, anybody can tell you anything. You are just there. You are the most dangerous man because you are going to be so disastrous for yourself and for those who hang around you. Because what you are doing is you are getting information into your mind, and that information will direct your emotions. You know, some people say, I don't feel like a man, even though I'm a man, I feel like a woman. You know why they feel like a woman? They've been exposed to information that tells them that they're women. So because they've been exposed to an information that tells them they're women, they have gender crisis. And because they have gender crisis, that crisis has become real because their mind has embraced it and configured their emotions. It's in the mind. All of these lesbians, homosexuals, those given to bestiality, all of these bisexuals, all of them are victims of identity crisis. They expose themselves to an information that programmed and configured their feelings. So you see a man, disgusting. And you wonder, he says, that's how I was born. No, he was not born like that. He was exposed to an information at a point of his life where he was not guarded, where he was not protected, either by his parents or by his guardians. Nobody was protecting him, and he himself didn't know what to protect himself from. So he exposed himself to an information that configured his emotions. That's why he's feeling like a woman. You wonder what's wrong with him. Everything is wrong with him, beginning from what he heard, which conditioned what he thinks, which affected how he feels, and now affects how he acts. All right, so such people are not hopeless. Such people are not evil. Such people are not bad. They are victims of circumstances. They are in dire need of help. They do not call for our judgment because you have not been where they were. Maybe if you were where they were, you would have been worse than them. You've got to be where somebody is first and not be like he is to be able to judge him. But if not been, you've not been where he is, you don't judge him. You look for how to help him. That's why God doesn't judge us. He comes into our circumstances and he helps us out of our circumstances. God commended his love towards us in that while we were yet sinners, Christ didn't judge us. God sent not his son into the world to judge the world, but that through him the world might be saved. So when you see people in certain very uncomfortable conditions, don't be judgmental because you have not been where they have been. So you don't understand what they were exposed to. Am I talking to somebody here? You show some understanding, show some compassion, show some love. If that's all you do, is enough. But you can go beyond that and help to bring such people out. We have a ministry of reconciliation, not a ministry of destruction. Teaching good this morning. They were exposed to information. You know, when you have some children that are abused by the gate man, abused by the house help, abused by an uncle, it's not their fault. Somebody that was meant to protect them was careless. And they didn't know what to protect themselves from. They were vulnerable and somebody took advantage of them. You don't look at them judgmentally. You look for how to help. Such people, they didn't put themselves into those conditions. So that's why you reach out with understanding. You reach out. Bible says, if a man be overtaken in a fault, ye that are spiritual, restore such a one in the spirit of meekness, not judgmental. In the spirit of meekness, considering yourself, lest you also be tempted. Meaning that what they are going through, you're not better than them. Maybe if you're in their shoe, you will have been worse than them. So let there be an understanding as you seek to help people. Am I teaching good? Please, this is very important. What I'm teaching you is very critical to life. And when your emotions are conditioned, it forms the perception of your life. It ultimately forms your perceptions.